Alright, so this is a new product visualization inside Blender, and in this lesson we are going to start a new product design, and we haven't uploaded any product design for a long period of time, and your host now is Camera Tommy. So let's get started by making a curve, and this curve will be a Bezier curve, and I will scale on the y-axis to be 0. We haven't enable the screencast case, so it's better to enable, and maybe changing the font size to be 20. And this is a Bezier curve. And what I'm going to make, if we have going to the dimensions, you will see that this item has around 2 meters long, and 2 meters is pretty long, and we will scale it to be around maybe 0.4. And let's zoom in, and after that we can select this one and scale. We can scale this one also like this, and after that I will extrude some time here and extrude another time here, and this may be rotating and extruding like this, and rotate, then scale like this. So this is our reference for the cable. Maybe moving it to be here and scale. Then we can rotate this one like this and scale another time. Alright, we have now done the curve. Let's see what our dimensions. It's around 1 meter. It's also very a big size, and we will make the origin to geometry, and let's scale it around 0.45 and scale it around 0.2, and this is our cable. We can move it to the center. So we will go now to the curve, and it will be 3D 12 and 12. It will be full, and the geometry will be bevel or depth around 0.1. let's test it. It's the depth is big, so we also want to apply all rotation and scale, and then test around 0.01. so 0.01 is good enough for our case, and the resolution may be 2 by 6. We will make this resolution 2 by 6 for now. If you want to increase the resolution, you can increase the resolution. After that, we can make it to be a mesh. So alt C doesn't work. So we can go to object, convert to mesh from to be a mesh from curve. But before that, we can rename it to be a design, and after that we can move it to a new collection like this, and this collection will be named extra objects, or you can rename it trash can or anything, because we may reference or go back to this initial cable. So I have made deduplicate it and move it to be here, but we didn't duplicate it, so I will move again to our design. Let's hide this also, and we can go now for object and convert it to be an mesh. Let's see our mesh, and everything is like we have expected, and it now have this. Let's move it to be here, and we have here around 16 vertex. All right. The next step is to, after making the cable, we can make the extra object. So how we can do this? I will select this one and maybe scale on X to be 0 and Shift D to duplicate, and after that I will separate by selection. Then we can go to select this one and maybe extrude in X axis to this distance, and the scale Shift X around 1.35, Then I will make around 3 loop cuts here. After that, we can bevel, control B to bevel. Then we have this, and I think it's maybe to select this one and enable proportional editing and scale shift X. Scale shift X 1.25. Anyway, we will go back after the disable the proportional editing, and I will select all faces except the top one and the bottom one. Alright, then we can extrude scale like this and maybe 0.85. Again, we will make the same here, deselect the all and extrude scale 0.85. After that, we can select this one also, and for this one we can deselect all these and another time. Alright, we will extrude again, extrude scale, maybe 0.85, and we can make some loop cuts here. Alright, we can go to add the subdivision surface, and maybe we can go for render 3, and as you can see we must set loop cuts here and loop cuts here in all these elements, and can be here and it can be here. Alright, now we have done what we can make here. We can, let's go back and isolate this one. We can select this one and extrude scale like this. Alright. And you can now set the shading to be a smooth. If you have the time, you can make something which is pretty handy. You can add some detail here. In the original model we have this one, we can select all these faces, and the other, this is extra to add some detail, or these two also, these two only I mean, and you can go to add bridge edge loop which is here, but this is extra detail. If you want to add, we can add like this. I will show you how we can add this. We can select this one and delete the faces, and let's disable it for a moment, and let's again disable this and come to delete all these faces, and we can select this face which is here. I will fill this one, and go back to the this view and make the cursor here and fill again and select this edge and fill 2 times. This is the extra detail that you want to add. And this detail is already in the original model, and I have done it to show you that it can be made like this. Anyway, we can go back. If you have the time, you can add also in the other side. Let's see what we have. As you can see, there is this cable isn't so smooth. You can add some subdivision surface like this. Anyway, let's make our finished design. So I will select this one and go back. Shift S cursor selected and add another plane. This plane will be scaled sometimes like this. And let's move to this area and scale in Y.6 and let's go back and scale in alright. Now I will go to move it in the Z axis like this and extrude in the axis like this, and maybe selecting this face and move to this area, select all and scale in the Y. Alright, we have some detail in this, so we can add some two loop cuts here and maybe select this one and slide to this area, and we will select also two here and then select this face and extrude to this direction. Again, we have to make a loop cut here and some loop cut here and enable or add subdivision surface. For now, it's isn't so detailed, so let's add the loop cut to define our edges, and another time it must be here. All right, we can now add smooth shading, and we have the USB cable. So this is a cable that attached one side to the phone and the other side is attached to the PC. So we can select this and these edges, duplicate all these edges. We have now 6 edges, so you can duplicate and move to other object or separate by object, and maybe selecting all this one and the scale on Y axis and the move in the Y axis like this, extrude in X axis straight, select all and scale in the axis such as this. If you want this edges, you see that they are extra, you can delete. Then we have to add loop cuts and two loop cuts here, and maybe slide it, or let's go to scale it on the y-axis, and we can go and move it to be an bevel and let's scale it in the x-axis and delete this extra face. Anyway, we can also make some loop cut here, and let's again, this is from the top and this is from the bottom, and add the solidify modifier. I will add loop cuts here, and let's go back. We are here to define something. We will deselect all, and I want to mirror the top to be the bottom, so select, let's select all this one, shift S cursor to selected, and set origin to the 3D cursor, and after that you can mirror in the Z axis. Again, we are now done, but we want to add some solidify. Firstly, you can apply this one, and it's around 1 millimeter. 1 millimeter isn't too small, so we can add 0.05 and apply. Alright, we can add this one and scale on Y axis, and let's go back. Alright, I think the solidify isn't the best solution because we have this, so let's go back and disable the solidify modifier. We can select all, and let's make the cursor to be here, shift S cursor to selected, select all, and make sure that you have set the pivot point to the 3D cursor, and extrude scale like this, shift X, and scale in Z like this. Now we are now done for this. If you want to apply the subdivision surface, you will see that you have this shape, and we can define the edges here. Alright, so we are now done for the first part. In the next part, we will add the other side.